Hi guys, welcome to this week's Fix It. Today we're looking at the sumo deadlift, okay? Now, we do a regular deadlift with a straight bar in our programming. Next program, we're looking to go into more of a sumo deadlift. Reason being, it is going to allow you to get into a more upright position, okay? And we're gonna be working different parts of the hip, okay? So it's gonna be a little bit more hip dominant, okay? So, when we are going to our deadlift, sumo deadlift, first thing we're gonna look at is the stance of the feet. Now we're just gonna go a little bit wider than usual, hence the sumo part of the name. Now I tend to go outside shoulder width. I've got quite long legs, so I can go a little bit wider. We don't want to go too wide because that's gonna encourage knees dipping in, okay? So just outside shoulder width is pretty good. And you're gonna think about feet facing 10 to 2 on the clock. Okay, so you're in this position here when you start. I'm gonna approach the bar, nice and close, nice wide stance, feet pointing 10 to 2, and my knees are gonna travel in the direction of my toes, okay? So I'm gonna go down, grab hold of the bar at shoulder width, okay? So hands on the shoulders, roll the bar in, bump slightly higher than your knees, so you are gonna engage your hamstrings, and you are going to try and stay nice and upright. Chest up, looking forward, drive up, push the floor away, shoulders back, squeeze the bum, and then back down. Now this move is very similar to a sumo squat. A key indicator, if you're doing a sumo squat rather than a deadlift, is that you're going to be clipping your knees with the bar when you're lowering and when you're lifting, okay? So that's one thing to bear in mind. If you do hit the knees, then you need to push your bum back a little bit further, okay? Very similar movements. That's this week's Fix It. Have a play with that one, guys, and enjoy the next program.